Oh, hello, Sir Beats. It's funny you should buy me. I'm not too far from where you are, just on the east coast of England, but I wasn't born here. Me and my family have come over from Scandinavia, from Denmark. We're Vikings. We went over in what we call longboats, which are what they say they are, big longboats. But we're quite in modest boats. They were quite small in comparison to the big dragon boats. The big dragon boats, they're what the warriors have. They have holes in the side where they put the shields in to protect them. They row through as well. And they can put the swords through as well to attack people. People don't come after us if we're next to the dragon boats. But the journey was difficult. It stank. It really, really stank. You think all them hundreds of years ago, seasickness and diarrhea and all sorts of things. It was horrible. But we had to do it. There's no farmland left. No farmland left in Denmark. It was hard to sleep. We didn't get any sleep. But we did a lot of fishing. We'd fish off the side and we'd catch all sorts of cods and stuff like that. And we had to come over. We had to come over to the East Coast. We came to Yorkshire. They knew it was good farming land because the farming land had gone. But people just didn't come to England or didn't stay in Denmark or go to Norway, they went everywhere. People don't know this, but Vikings went up to Greenland, we went up to Iceland, we even went to Canada long, long before anyone else did. Some of my cousins and some of my clan have gone into Turkey and Russia and even into Israel. Some of them gone on camels and they carried the longboats from river to river. Trepid travellers and gone far throughout the land. A lot of people think we're just warriors, and the warriors are amazing. There's pride. People prefer to die with pride than to live without. Once they die with pride, they go to Valhalla, and their lives are remembered and they become a myth. But I'm not like that. I'm just a farmer. With me, my wife Helena, and my children. I spend my days on...
Sorry about that.
Just come back, my wife Helena. She just grabbed me again. There's a bit of an issue with the longhouse. You see, we have a middle, a fire in the middle of the longhouse, and an ember had gone astray, so I had to put it out and make sure no damage had happened to it. But our houses are different to yours. You have small houses, they're made of bricks. We have big longhouses. It's not just us who live in there. There's other families as well. And it's the cows and the sheep. They live all in one section. We live in the other section. We kind of have thatch roofs as well. They're a bit like the barns that you have now, but I think more comfortable as well. But there's always repairs to be doing because they're made out of wood and we build them all ourselves when we moved to another place, when we moved here to Yorkshire. We had to build our own long house and we'd help other families as well to build theirs. And we're very proud of them. And sometimes you just get a bit stinky and it's a bit hard to sleep. It's nice, and that's what you Britons, this is what you think of us as well. You think we're stinky, we're not stinky. You're stinky. We have baths once a week, and you think that's too much. We have outdoor lavatories, and you don't. You think that's disgraceful. Some of us men even put makeup on when going to war. You lot don't do that. We're nice and clean. We're good people. And I'll tell you what, if I could afford it, I'd have some lovely clothes as well. You see, I've got very basic clothes because I'm just a farmer. But warriors and landowners, they have a lot more. They like to show off their wealth by having big houses, but also with jewellery and swords and things like that. They have cloaks on them as well. They like to show their wealth by having more layers. So the more layers you've got, the more money you've got, the more colourful the clothes, the more money you've got as well. So people like to show off, just like you do now. But they like to do it in a different way. But hopefully one day, hopefully me moving to Yorkshire with my family, I mean that one day I can own all these nice things, but we'll see how we get on. But anyway, I'm going to have to go because my wife Helen is hauling me again. Problem with the sheep in the farm, I think. But I'll see you in a bit. Sorry. me again. Sheep got loose the longhouse, running around causing some right havoc through the fire, scaring the kids. The wife, she's supposed to look after the kids and livestock, but sometimes she struggles. You know, I need to get there and sort it out, really, but such is life. Anyway, I just wanted to say a lovely speaking to you. Fantastic to hear about your life, and hopefully you enjoyed hearing about mine. If you want to know any more, please write to me. My name's Knook. If you go to your teacher, she's got my address, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye.